I got PTSD. It took me 20 years.
20 years to
go through the process. Actually, it's over 20 years, more like 25 years. Then you have to learn how to handle it and deal with situations out here so that you don't get caught up in a situation that's going to mess you up. So it's tough. It's tough. It ain't easy.
My problem, it took me 20 years before I found out I had it.
When you finally realized that you had PTSD, what were the signs?
Oh, I was doing a whole lot of crazy stuff.
Yeah, I was in 101st Airborne, 3rd 187th Infantry. We had what we called a lung clock. On guard duty, you took a frag grenade, pulled the pin, threw the pin away, and you held the frag. And you sit down and wait, so if you went to sleep, you wake everybody else up. I didn't sleep at night without being drunk or high for 25 years.
Myself, I pulled ambush on the Ho Chi Minh Trail. Just go out, set up ambush, and try to get all the weapons to come down the Ho Chi Minh Trail. And you didn't know when you was going to get attacked. You know, you just out there. You know. All of a sudden, all hell break loose, you know. And that's be, you know, you feel that, you know. You come back home, you still feel them shooting at you and all that kind of stuff. It's pretty bad. It's pretty bad.
Did anyone here serve in Iraq? You did? First Gulf War?
First Gulf War. But, you know, when I first got out of the military, I thought I had made it through my career and I was out pretty safe. And, I guess it was probably 10 years after I got out of the military that my wife woke me up one night with my hands around the neck. And that's when I decided to go get some help.
Would there be benefit in having more funds, more attention to good counselors rather than pills?
I'm sure that would be a lot more beneficial than, you know, going through somebody giving you a sleeping pill. You know, for me, I average about 4 hours sleep a day at night. And then in that 4 hours, I'm doing a little of everything, you know, fighting, screaming, kicking, punching. So you wake up in the morning, you got bruises on your hands, your feet, your legs, holes in the wall of your house. And you don't know what happened sometimes because you slept through it, but you were very active. You know, my wife says she can tell when they're coming on because I started making a noise. So she'd get up and go to another bedroom somewhere to sleep. It all comes out at night.
Yeah.
I think all veterans, that anybody that served in the military, deserve to be able to go to the VA hospital and be taken care of. That's all veterans, all of them.
But that's what they tell everybody.
But it don't happen that way.
I know it.
No.
Everybody that signed on, even when I signed, once you go in, you will always have these services for you. And the simplest thing, when I came in, I used to tell Larry right now, when I got out of school, the first thing they did, they cut the GI Bill out. Mm-hmm. And that was one of the reasons we was in there. They were saying, you ought to go to college.
Well, right now, President Trump, 45, has announced that he wants to put a lot more money, in the defense budget. Do you think any of that is going to come down to programs like this?
No.
So it's not a priority.
No, they want more toys. We need more for the soldiers. Yeah. Not more toys to go boom. Yeah. Well, it seems like it's always the same case. We want to go to war, everybody gung-ho. Well, get these young kids, take them out of high school, throw them in there, put them all out there. Let's go boom-boom somebody. Right. What happens when the time's up? Mm-hmm. When the boys come home, they're missing parts, and they're missing parts up here, too. We forgot about y'all. We looking for the next boom boom. They don't worry about, well, if you put these kids in harm's way, you got to take care of them the rest of your life, the rest of their life, rather. Somebody up there needs to be thinking.
When you look at the younger kids coming out of Afghanistan now, for example, what do you see the problems? What kind of problems are they having?
I think they're having psychological issues.
Yeah, most of it's going to be PTSD.
They got anger issues, serious anger issues.
Yes. Same thing. And a lot of them are getting locked up.
Yeah.
by the time that they figure out that they do have issues, they've already messed up and there's no one there. When they come out, I think they should be going through some type of system when they come out to be evaluated.
Like set up for 6 or 8 weeks somewhere, they can stay and be evaluated. Yeah. And they can sit around groups and talks and things that way. And the counselors can pick up on certain things.
Find out what their problems are. And then they could start working with their problems before they go out and do something crazy. Yeah.
So VA needs to be doing job search, training, immediate help right after you get back on American soil.
Right.
I mean, right now we have a congressman who is not addressing the needs of this district. His office is often closed, and certainly closed to people who would like to.
I've never seen him in Franklin County.
Exactly.
The thing about now is people's voice is not being heard. We are not being heard at all. We're being silenced.
So we know where the problem is, and that's why I'm standing around this table. We all got to know where our problem is. That's how important it is why we have to go to the polls, and we have to start learning who we need to put in and who we need to take out. That is one of the. That's one thing we can do.
I'm optimistic because I see the blue wave coming, but.
There is a wave.
We have
there
to
is a wave. Yes,
we have to do our part too.
Mm-hmm.
We have to turn out and vote. We have to turn out all the people that we know to vote.
My question is, if you get elected after hearing everything that went on,
yep.
Do you think you can help?
I do. The job is to serve. The job is not to rule, it's to serve.
It seems like a lot of them in D.C. have forgotten that.
They have forgotten that, but it's time to turn that around.